So, hello y'all, welcome to another video of my YouTube channel, Esoteric Cloud Surfer. In this channel we create lighter, as in weight, light bodies, aka esoteric clouds, that when our spirit go into those bodies, that are also less dense and vibing on a higher frequency and vibration, our spirit can travel to higher, more expanded, bigger realms of reality. So, in this video, I want to talk about... Wait, just putting the space key more clean. So I want to talk about something that I've seen in a Dolo the Pilot Man live stream, but that I always talked about. And I was thinking, because I just woke up from a nap. Respect your naps, take your naps, respect your body when you feel tired. When you feel exhausted, either emotional, either physically or mentally, take a nap, rest a little bit, and then you can get more creative and better ideas how to endure the circumstances that lead you to exhaustion. Just rest in general. So I took a nap. I came from the inn with some ideas and I was thinking about it. And wait a moment, some water. And what Dolo talked in this, I think it was it last live stream from yesterday, one of the things, it was like how the Aries and Aquarius are arrogant, right? How they, the initial letter of the name of the constellation can describe an attribute, one of many attributes, but one more general attribute of one solar, lunar or rising sign, or one constellation that you may have in your own natal chart, right? So I'm just complicating a bit this introduction because I'm still thinking about it, okay? So let's get into it. So Aries, right, starts with an A. So it's arrogant, like Dolo said. So I was thinking then Taurus, right, Taurus. Taurus, what do I come up personally to say what Taurus are, right? Well, first I thought like Taurus are tenacious, but then, okay, it fits, tenacious starts with a T, and Taurus can be tenacious, they can be focused and passionate about their own fixed way to be practical and to have comfort and safety, right? But it didn't satisfy that spaceship that I've created. So then I remembered about a linguistic, right, about language and the origin of words. I think that is called enneology, I'm not sure, but I also want to take this chance to give a shout out to Seven Bomar. If you have watched Seven Bomar, maybe you know what I'm talking about. If you haven't watched yet, it's not a waste chance. He has a lot of interesting videos. He's also like 10 years on YouTube, like Dolo, delivering a message in a different way, but it's also a very, very good message. I do believe that his soul group, all right, in its own way. And one of the very important things that I learned, or that I start to explore by watching Seven Bomar, was the origin of the words, the origin of the meaning, why those words are because words are worlds. And a word, the letters that are in the word, make the world that you go into when you talk, when you say that word, or when you are in the same state of spirit, that word was devised or original created to put you in, right? Because somebody came up to that word, somebody invented that word, and they were in a state of spirit, in a specific state of spirit, in the moment that they created that word. And enneology, and you understanding why that word is spelled in that way, because spelling is casting is a spell, words are spells. You spell a word, it's a spell. But when you start to think about it, you can really understand the meaning, the true space where that word came from. And then you see that from one space, from one state of being, can arise different words, right? And you then can connect some dots, but that's just coming out of this video. So then Taurus, right? Taurus starts with a T, but through English I didn't come up with a very good word. But then I remembered that Taurus, the word Taurus, is, I'm not sure, but I'm very positive that it comes from Latin, alright? Or from some kind of Latin dialect. Because remember, Aries, Taurus, Gemini, these are just names that people that were looking at the sky gave to those constellations. Aries is not Aries. Aries is a group of stars. It's not Aries. Aries is a name that people here, looking at the constellation, to the group of stars, gave to Aries, right? So, a lot of the names of that we use in Zodiac, to call them Zodiac constellations, came from Romans, and Romans used Latin, or from Greeks, but Greeks is a little more confused because it's a lot of roots coming into the Greeks. So, but then I fixated my spaceship in Latin, right? So, Latin and Portuguese, my native tongue, comes from Latin. And Taurus in English will be the bull, right? The bull. But in Portuguese, the bull is touro. And it's very like Taurus, right? So, the T is still in touro. So, Touro and Taurus came from the same state of being, from the same space. So they are in a shape, in a way they are connected. So they mean the same thing. So then I was thinking, Taurus in English is stubborn, right? But stubborn do not start with a T, it starts with an S. But stubborn in Portuguese, it's teimoso. Being stubborn in Portuguese, we call it teimoso. And it starts with a T, right? And then, through exploring seven Bormar content, and through then doing those associations by myself, I've learned that S, the letter S, means knowledge from the earth, means lower down knowledge, all right? A sage is a person that knows very much about the earth, about the elements in earth, about how to be powerful in earth. But getting too lost in the S, in the earth, can make you a serpent, an S, and you lose focus of the big picture of the general space of all possibilities, and you start to know too much when you get fixated and you get stagnated in learning things about the earth, because there are many, many things to learn about the earth, about the snake, because we live in a snake, in a water big influence being. But that's not, yeah. You then start to be demonic and you forget about all possibilities and you just think that you think that all things are like things in earth, but it is not. So S means from the earth, being a serpent, because you, instead of you looking at the sky, you now are always looking forward and you are walking with your belly, you are walking with your desires. That's what happened when you get lost into the S, when you get lost into the desires world, when you get lost into earth, into the demiurge, right? So the S in stubborn means that people are stubborn or teimoso, all right, about things of the earth, and that is the perfect example for Taurus, right? Stubborn Taurus. So Taurus is stubborn, all right, because language is a program. It programs how we perceive reality and how we receive reality. So whoever, the group of people who've created English, they knew that, they knew astrology, they knew about spirituality, they knew about words are worlds, yeah, right? So they did some things that they wanted to achieve, all right? But we can decipher through those things, all right, with our own inner knowledge, with our own inner wisdom, and we say, oh, that S in stubborn is just for us to be stubborn, to be Taurus-like about Earth, and we forget about the rest, and now there is a general concept that Taurus is about getting fucked, is about getting a lot of money, is about going out to eat, and we confuse that with materialism, but it's not about that, alright? So then, Gemini starts with a G, right? So, with this one, I haven't really thought about it, alright? I really thought about Taurus, and then I just thought, oh, I start talking about it and it should flow. So Gemini starts with a G, right? A G. And the letter G is like, is presenting God, right? It's like, by we, also we can learn from the format, from the shape of the letters, right? Because those are signs of transits in the sky or of how energy moves. So G, I should have my whiteboard here. I don't use it in a very long time. So the G comes from here, like, almost like a six, and it goes into a middle. So it's like attracting energy. So it's attracting or focusing energy and attention. So Gemini, they can be greedy, they can be gossipy. Of course, Gemini is gossipy, because when you do gossip, you attract the energy of the surroundings into your awareness. Because if you don't do gossip, you don't know what's around you or what is the going on around you, or people, how people are feeling around you, how spirits are flowing around you. While if you do gossip and you talk with that person and with that person and with that person, you know about those circumstances, you know about those current events. So now you, by being aware of it, you are part of it. So gossip, it's like a G who brings attention into your awareness because you are aware of others' events. Then from Gemini we have Cancer. Dolo said they were complicated. I will not deny that, because they are initiating new ways to feel and how to, just new waves of emotions and new waves of events. So Cancers, they are ruled by the moon. So they are very focused on comfort, but they are always creating new ways to feel about it. So they feel comfortable. Oh, now they are in a new space, so they feel uncomfortable. That's why they are complicated. I just made a video about that, how cardinal energy can bring those feelings of uneasy or fear, because you are in a comfortable, you create you initiate something. Now you're comfortable. But because you have a lot of cardinal energy, if your chart, if you do, now you initiate again. So you go into a new space again. And if you don't know how to be fixed, you will live always like that, very stressful. Your hair might start to fall out. So chill on that. That's why Cancers are complicated, because they like comfort, but then they transform that comfort into uncomfortability in some way, shape and form. So be aware of that. Then Leos are liars, and Libras, they are liars because they are light, because Leo is ruled by the sun. And what is the most common fact about the sun? That the sun brings the light, the sun brings the heat. That's not true. I also have a video about that. It's my video recently, recent video about stars. The sun does not bring the heat. The connection, the interaction between the sun and our star, what we call Earth, Gaia, Tiamat, Maya, all right, Maya, Gaia, when it's that interaction that brings the heat and the light that we see, right? So, some water first. And water, that I will take some chances that we are in the world, the word world. We are talking about words like water starts with W and world starts with a W. And the W, it's a W, it's a double reflection. You, when we say you, the letter U, you start in this point. You go down into your desires and then you ascend in another point. So a W is doing that two times. It's light bending in on light. Because light is your first reflection. Then light reflects on itself, it bends in, it becomes more dense, and now we live in the third dimension that is very dense. It's light within light. That's why there is two types of lights in this world. We have the yang light, it's the light that we can see. And then we have the yin light, that is the light that we can see as well. Feelings, emotions, that is connected to intuition. But yeah, Leos are liars, because they use the light from the sun to hide those lights that we can't see. Because the lights that we can see can hide the lights that we can't see. And the lights that we can't see can hide our true spirit, our true space, our true frequency and vibration. So Leos, they are fire, right? So they take things from their internal process and they express that. So they use the lights that we can't see to produce lights that we can see. So the lights that we can see through actions and expressions covers the internal true lights, because Leos are proud on their own way to express. So they will be fixated on that. But it doesn't mean that they are fixated on their internal feelings. Their internal feelings can change a lot, but they will transform that light that we can see, that yin light, that is different, into the same type of yang light that we can see. That's why they are liars. It doesn't mean they are lying to hurt you. Most times they are lying to protect themselves, so you can see what's really going on, because they want you to see this and not my face. See the hand. The hand is always beautiful. The face, I don't know. You can see it, right? But they know, so they can then manipulate through that. Then Virgos. Virgo starts with a V, and the V, it's very interesting, because in Portuguese, in old Portuguese, in archaic Portuguese, that was very early transition from Latin and other languages, the V would be the U, right? Portugal, it was Portugal, like in, if you can imagine those words. So the V and the U are correlated. So think about it, the U is like this, right? And the V is like this. So it's like the same thing, you reflecting yourself in these lower waters, in these more dense waters, but it's more direct. It's more tum tum, instead of being like, it's more tum-tum. It's very fast. And Virgo, it's ruled by Mercury, one of the fastest planets. It's very mental and it's organized, it's mutable. It takes the earth, the practicality, and gives it a spark. So it's, if it's not V, I don't know what it is. Coming very down to earth to reflect, you know? And also, they are a virgin, because Virgos are always nervous and worrying, because they are always in the new space. They are not like the cardinal energy, where they start with a feeling of comfort or power, because they are initiating. Mutable energy, especially Virgos, are in the end side of the stick, because they have to take something that somebody else started, that somebody else constructed and nourishment, and now they have to change it or destroy it. So they can feel very nervous, they can feel very unsure about themselves, because they feel they are never right. They need always to destroy it, because they are very direct. They don't take time to appreciate, they don't take time to learn. All they just learn what they think they need to learn. That's that V. And also, and why I'm connecting Portuguese so much with English, because English is a mixture of Latin, French that comes from Latin, German, and some other languages. And Portugal and England have one of the oldest alliances in the world. So Latin. Spanish comes from Latin, French comes from Latin, Portuguese comes from Latin, the language spoken in Romania comes from Latin, alright? So Latin is, or things that derive from Latin, is almost everywhere in the world, but Latin is a made-up language. I used to be more sure about that, because I used to have some videos that I was to remember about things that... It was like Pig Latin, research Pig Latin, and you might connect to the space that I'm talking about now, how Latin is a made-up language. But so, because Portugal and Spanish and but more Portugal is in alignment from since the early ages to England, Portuguese and English are very connected in terms of linguistic. And also remember very quickly that was the Portuguese that started to spread Christianity to the world through the Age of Discovery. If you don't know about that, search Portugal discovery of Africa, Brazil and things like that. And Portuguese people even reached Japan and reached Australia. And they were the Portuguese people who reached Japan and Australia, they were Jesuits. And if you watch Dolo, you know what I'm talking about. If you're a soul group, you know what I'm talking about, right? So, and it's very funny because I'm now remembering that sometime two friends of mine went to watch a movie about Portuguese Jesuit priests going to Japan preaching, and then my friends fell asleep watching the movie in the cinema. And if you know how they rock us to sleep, that's very funny, that conjunction of words. They go to see a movie about their mission, and they be rocked, they fell asleep. Bro, that's spirit talking. So Virgo, okay, it's direct. It's the you, the reflection, but direct. Then after Virgo, it's Libra. And Libra, it's also a liar, but it's a liar that comes after the V, after the Virgo. And what rules Libra? Venus, all right? And Libra takes that direction, that more direct reflection, and uses that to manipulate. Because Libra is masculine side, right? Is air, it's the yang of the N, the external of the external. And Leo is the external of the internal, that's the two L's, right? But Venus is also more external, is the external light, that's why it's a more external, more direct reflection, that V. So Libra uses that V to make it look that it's you, to make it look that it cares about, that it feels about something, that it feels about your desires and emotions. But no, just make it look like it. And sometimes Libras think they care about their relationships. Sometimes Libras, they believe in that, right? Because Libras, always be creating new ways to think about something, new ways to initiate new thinkings, they get lost in the sauce and they think they are always caring about something. No, they are just going around creating new ways to think about the same thing, right? Because they are Saturn, who rules Aquarius, is exalted in Libra, so Libras can be Aquarius. And Saturn is that L, right, as well. Why? Because, for example, in Israel, is from Isis, the moon. Ra is from the sun, L is from Saturn. So L is Saturn, Leo. Leo is opposing Aquarius, is opposing the sign that is ruled by Saturn. Why? Because Leo is ruled by the sun, and Saturn was our sun once upon a time. So what the sun is already learning, Saturn already know. And because the sun is about individuality, the sun is very prideful. Leo are very prideful. They like to keep their pride because the sun doesn't want to share, doesn't want to show that he's learning what Saturn already knows. The sun doesn't want you to see and recognize that the sun is still learning, while we have Saturn that knows what the sun already knows and even more. So Libra, exalted, Leo opposing the sun, that Saturn talk. Then after Leo, we have Scorpio. They are secretive because, or they are sexual, or they are that S. And Scorpios, it was very strong connection in my mind. I don't have that Aquarius stellium. Right, and that Mars in Libra. So Scorpios is that S, and they oppose Taurus, that they are stubborn. They are that S of the Earth, and Taurus is ruled by Venus and Earth. So Scorpios, they might oppose Taurus, but they are about Earth, they are about desires, they are about this realm of indulgence, of desires, of temptations, of, you know, temptations, Taurus. Right? So they are secretive because they don't want to share those things with people that don't understand their own fixed way. Because Scorpios, they are the most wise, they have that S about this earth, about what means to be on earth, to know that safety, when there is a breach in your safety, when life changes, that is not bad, and you do not suffer like a Taurus. Suffer. Scorpios know how to suffer. Scorpios value suffer. That's why a Scorpio can be chaotic, because they only value suffer. They only value transformation. They are scared with stability. Scorpios can be scary. because that S as well, or they can be always scared because they see a moment of stability, a moment of stagnation, and they get bored, they get needy, they get bitchy, and they start to transform every bit of stability and comfort. So they are secretive because they cannot do that always, so they will sacrifice money and relationship and status, so they keep that secret and they only share with people who understand their own way to transform and be chaotic. Then, after Scorpio, we have Sagittarius, which is also secretive, but Sagittarius is more about being sage, a wise person, about the Earth, and it's because it starts with that S, and then it has that A, so it's that Earth ascension, right? Scorpio is C, S, C, it's Earth caring, complicating the Earth, because Cancer is about caring as well, the C is about the care, right? Because the C is you coming up from a higher place, you reflect on yourself, and you come out in a lower place, so you care, your spirit cares about Earth, Moon. It's Cancer is ruled by the Moon, and the Moon is the most, it's the closest body to Earth, so it's more powerful in manifesting because you care more about the Earth, so your spirit can be more motivated and more creative and more fixated, ironically, in manifesting things down here on Earth, because you come from a higher point, your spirit, the higher dimensions, 4, 5, and 6 dimension, and you come to the lower right dimensions, that's the C. So Scorpio, it's the S, Earth, Serpent, desires, caring. Sagittarius is S, Earth, lower desires, ascension. And the symbol, the description, the representation for Sagittarius is a centaur, half animal, half man, coming from Earth, coming from the horse, coming from the lower desires, coming from the animalistic natures to the man, to a higher form, but still having the Sagitta, the arrow pointing to the star, an even higher ascension, an even higher way of living, an even higher virtue and principle, right? So Sagittarius, they can get confused and they think they are sages, but they can ascend in Earth. Or while they are ascending, they get scared or they get secretive because it's too much. They are coming from they are coming from animal, man, star. It can be too much, okay? Because we are still on Earth. If you weren't on Earth, if you weren't animalistic still, you wouldn't be on Earth, right? Then, after Sagittarius, we have Capricorn. They are also complicated because they care about not caring. They care about not being comfortable. So they always are creating new ways, or they are always initiating new responsibilities, new stress, new plans, new trends as well, because it's new realities, new possibilities in Earth. So they care because it's that Moon energy, and the Moon is the closest to the Earth, but they are always putting or placing those things into worth, about contracts, about being firm on your decisions and your construct, caring. It always starts with a C, and Saturn is a planet of connection, networking, because it's exalted in Libra, of contracts, limits and boundaries. You cannot do what is not in this contract. You are limited and boundary to this contract. So that's Capricorn initiating new contracts because they care about stability, but they want to create new stability so that they don't get too stuck, but they want to preserve some form, some sense of security. So they do contracts, they do connections, they do inner networks, they do inner connections, their own internal network with their own chakras. They know, because the internet is the internal net, is your internal inside net of organizations, of organs, and Capricorn is about infrastructure, about government, so that's internal because it's the feminine side of Saturn, so it's all internal, your own organization, and your stomach is an organ, your brain is an organ, your dick or your pussy is an organ, your kidneys is an organ, and they are all organized. You are a nation, and Capricorn, it's caring about that. It's constructing in that internal, all right? And then comes Aquarius, who are arrogant because they think they know how to do that, but they don't. They know how to, we know how to get lost in space and do that, what Capricorns do in Earth, with care, with the moon. Here, Aquarius do with the A in ascension. We create those light bodies, but in space. That's why we're arrogant, because I'm here in this physical body, right? But sometimes I be over there looking at everybody else, including my body down here. And I be looking down on me. I be arrogant on me. I be looking down on that person, because I've made that organization, I've made that nation, I've made that contract, I've made that alignments, I've made those organs in space, in a higher A, ascension, because the A is the V backwards, is you coming from a lower point and reaching a higher point and then coming back with that learning. That's what we do. Esoteric Cloud Surfer, and I have Aquarius Stellium. My spirit enters, when I start a video, I'm in the third dimension, right? Then I ascend, we create an esoteric cloud, which is lighter, less dense, vibing on a higher frequency and vibration, so it floats in comparison to the density level of the third dimension. We reach a higher point, and then we came back to use that those higher knowledge, to use those higher wise experience to transform Aquarius, our Uranus, our lives down here. So that was a great enlightenment moment. So sometimes Aquariuses and Aries, they are arrogant because they create those, Aquarius create those higher shapes in space, outside, those higher vehicles. Aries create those higher vehicles inside. So they are both arrogant because Aries look to others' feelings like they enchant, because they are always creating new feelings and new ways to see the feelings and new ways to express the feelings. So others be carrying their feelings around and Aries be always expressing them. So Aries look up, arrogant, from a higher place, A, ascension, right, to others' feelings, like, ah, you can't handle your feelings. You can't express your feelings, while Aries can't handle their feelings. That's why they are always expressing them. That's why Aries sometimes get loner in the negative side, because they can't connect, because they can. They just are always creating new ways to feel about the connection, and they burn a comfortable and solid connection. That's why they're arrogant, because they have a connection and suddenly they put their feelings above the connection. Aquarius, they have a group of friends, they have a connection, they have a business. They put their higher mind chakras that they have created in space, looking down on Earth, and then it's like, ah, that business, it doesn't even matter. If they knew about all the space, if they knew about the spaceship I'm building up here, they'll do nothing. And then Aquarius come back and be like, oh, I spent so much time in the sky, in space, I forgot how to be in Earth. Now I have to ask for help. And now that A becomes a Q, Aquarius. It's a circle, a container that comes down. Aquarius ascend, creates a container, and then comes down because it detached too much. And then it's a U, a Q, Aquarius. It reflects on itself. A Q, Aries, then it ascends. Then the R brings the vibration, frequency and vibration. The R brings the movement. Aquarius, then it's the I, the individuality. You ascend and you create a stable container up there. Then you reflect about that and you learn about Earth. That's Aquarius for y'all. And why it was so easy for me to do this in Aquarius world and not in others, because I have an Aquarius stellium. That's how we do it. Our own alignment already let us know things for sure. For sure, you don't need to learn. There are some things that you don't need to learn. God damn it, you don't need to learn. You already know many things that you already learned spiritually, and now you know how to do it. But I will do on Patreon a video that is deciphering every constellation name word, because that's really how you be moving. If you are an Aquarius, that's how you move. You ascend, you descend. Then I'll do a proper video about that. And Aries, they ascend and they vibrate on that ascension. If you know about frequency and vibration, if you know about sound technology, if you know about Caesar, sound can travel faster than light. Shout out to Michael Tellinger. I saw like 2 years ago, in the early steps of my spiritual journey, I saw like a 2 or 3 hours presentation of his. I also saw a 6 or 5 hour presentation of about Seven Bomar. Those were like richest moments of my early spiritual stage. And I want to thank Daria because she helped me introduce to those spaces. We both together introduced.
Hi.
We both carry ourselves to those higher spaces of wisdom and knowledge. So shout out to Michael Tellinger, because through that perspective, through that presentation, I learned about Taurus field, I learned about frequency and vibration, I learned about how insects like bees, they don't fly, they levitate because of the vibration of the wings that they produce, right? Those things that look like veins in the wings, they're not veins, they are tubes, empty tubes that the air passes through the tubes and they vibrate the wings and then levitate, because by them vibrating, the density of their wings and the air around the wings is moving faster. So it's less demonic, it's less stable, it's less earth, because earth is stable. That's why we call this realm earth. We are not living on earth. Earth is an element. But this planet is so earth-like, is so stuck, is so stubborn, that we as spirits call it earth. But it's not true. It is just how a group of spirits want you to look at it, because they want it. They want their plan to be the same from a long time. They want to be in rulership for a long time. So they need for this frequency and vibration to be like this, instead of being like this and always changing, right? Because Earth is a wave. Earth can have any shape and form that the spirits living on Earth give to Earth through the frequency and vibration, through the sound, through the that's why by humming you can increase your manifestation. Cats, they heal, because I said cats because my cat is here sleeping by the heater. Cats, they purr, that makes them heal, because it's their own frequency and vibration, and their spirit is inside of their body, and that the body of the cat was created through the word God said, there it be light. God said. So God, through God is a spirit, is another word for spirit. That spirit vibrated and created light. God said, there it be light. Okay? So the God, the spirit of the cat, created a denser light, their body, through its frequency and vibration. So when the cat makes brrr, the cat is emanating the frequency and vibration, its own unique, that's fifth, that's throat chakra talk, okay? So when you hum, you do that to yourself. You feel your space, you feel your body and the smaller bodies inside of you with your own frequency and vibration, and that allows you to heal and to expand. But I'll make another video about that, because we entering Pisces, and Pisces are some powerful motherfuckers. That's why I've been divagating from so much, because with Aquarius you ascend, right? With Capricorn, with Sagittarius you ascend first, then you construct, and then with but Sagittarius is a no, forget it, erase. With Capricorn you care and construct a tower. Now you higher. Then with Aquarius you ascend even higher into space. And now in Pisces you create a container there. Remember how the P is constructed. The big P, the big cap B, is you coming from below, ascending through the Aquarius. And you build a circle up there. You build a house. You build a container. You build something that can hone in knowledge, wisdom and manifestations. And that's power of the Pisces, right? Pisces, the power of individuality, knowing about Earth, caring about knowing in all levels, because it's that E, you can start, the E can start from low, you ascend, now you build a stand, now you know about this level, then you go back, you ascend again, and you know about another level, so you know about three levels, and Pisces is the 12th sign of the zodiac, it knows about everything, so it's that E, that E letter that knows about every level, so it's Pisces, because it's Earth, again, because, but the S is in the end, and in Portuguese, many people joke with Portuguese language, because for us, and in English as well, the plural, many things, has the letter S in the end. Why? Because the first thing is the spirit, the second thing is the earth, the more dense realm. So the S means the more things, means plural. So Pisces does all of that process in the yin realm, in the spirit realm. And then it reaches earth with all of that. Power, individuality, knowing about earth, caring about that, but then knowing about more levels, knowing about three levels, third dimension, 12, 1 plus 2 is 3, right? Three levels of the letter E, and then in Earth again, because it reflects its water, it reflects all of that through their power. But Pisces are some powerful motherfuckers, because they can receive and connect very easily with other dreams. So Pisces is like fucked up for 30 years, then just catches a dream that is compatible, that is positive, and in 6 months, it's a millionaire. That's power of the P, power of that water. Pisces is 10 years not doing shit. Suddenly connects with a dream, with an imagination, with a creative endeavor, because that big grandma, because God, grandma, Neptune, grandma of Jupiter, big grandma, Jupiter, Neptune over there, just needs some Uranus. It comes from Aquarius. Uranus, that spark, it activates Neptune, and just that dream, that creativity, it's way bigger than Earth right now. Everybody on Earth is paying attention to your Neptune shit. So powerful, the power is in the P. It's Pisces. And Pisces is internal. It's water, it's feminine. So everybody out there doing phallic religion, trying to externalize, you lost, alright? So, that's the end of my, let's see how I will call this. I don't know. Enneology of the zodiac constellations, plus shout out to Seven Bomar and Michael Dellinger, perhaps. So, esoteric cloud surfer surfing out. I hope you enjoyed this long video. I hope you were doing some things while you're watching, make you feel good, because the video is long and I can express myself in a very cold and direct way. But if you can keep up with me, if you can jump into your Saturn spaceship and go with me, you can remember things as I am, because I didn't plan this video. While I was talking, I was learning, I was remembering things. So I hope you were with me on this spaceship. So until the next time, Esoteric Cloud Surfer, surfing out. Remember to stay an individual, look for that ascension, and then stabilize. Don't fall. Ascend, stabilize, and ascend again. Until the next time, be aware of the current events. Shout out to Daria, my beautiful partner. Shout out to Dula the Pilot Man. Check out my Instagram, check out my Patreon, check out my SoundCloud, check out my Linktree. Shout out to all of the Soul Group. We are changing the world right now. Until the next time, Esoteric Cloud Surfer, surfing out.